Joining us now from the Perth studio is David Paull from Aspire Mining. David, congrats on releasing your PFS on Ovoot. Let's, first of all, before we delve into the outcomes of the PFS, could you remind us about the scope of this PFS? It only covers a certain portion of the project, correct?
Hi, Danielle. Yes, it does. It's constrained to a starter pit, basically. The overall Ovoot reserve is 255 million tonnes, and we're looking at a starter pit which effectively funds an early start with the infrastructure, wash plant, road capital, etc., to give a project the start without having to wait for rail. So we're still working on rail in the background, but this gives us, within our control, a fast startup. And it's quite exciting. The mandate was to get production up to 4 million tonne per annum, which is the existing capacity available to us in the Mongolian rail system. So that's what we have done. And we've proven the concept, which is identifying a low strip ratio, high yielding part of the deposit, and creates a fantastic financial outcome.
We do understand that the purpose of the Ovoot Early Development Program was to accelerate those cash flows. So why don't you tell us about those key metrics in this PFS?
Sure. The overall metrics, based on an average $150 a tonne coal price at the Chinese border, gives us a net present value just on the OEDP itself of just under $600 million on a 10% before tax basis, internal rate of return of over 40% before tax. And it's based on a capital spend of about $110 million at the mine, including a pre-strip, plus a capital for a road construction. We have about $165 million. And that's all repayable within 2 years based on the high margin we've got in the project. So the payback's 2 years. We're looking at EBITDA at full production at 4 million tonne per annum of over $170 million before tax, obviously. So the metrics are very robust. It's only over a small proportion of the overall 255 million tonnes. It's only 15% of that reserve. So there's lots of added value we'll add over time. But what it shows you is we have a very sweet starting position, pays for all the capital, tremendous financial outcomes, and helps us fund future development of the project to its full potential.
Can you remind us about those other development options beyond this 9-year mine life and this particular portion of the reserves and resources that you're going after in terms of whether rail comes to fruition or not?
Yeah, the idea of the OEDP is to get us into production before rail. So within the term of that 9 years development, if the rail is developed, you then have a production scenario that can rise up to 10 million tonne per annum for plus 15, 18 years. So that creates an overall project timeline of about 27, 28 years. In the event you don't proceed with rail, for whatever reason, there are extensions to this current deposit you can do. Now, we've actually demonstrated that in the PFS by showing what the value of one extra cutback can do. So with one extra cutback, the next obvious one, we end up with another three and a half years of mine life. And brings the NPV of the project up to just south of $750 million using the same parameters, because essentially the capital has already been invested and paid for in the initial project. Now we can continue on and look at additional cutbacks in the future in the event you don't have rail, and it can have a further development and a long life mine at that 4 million tonne per annum level.
Final question, David, what is next? What are those timeframes for the next stages of development?
Sure. Well, the board has approved going directly to a definitive feasibility study, and that has now commenced. So we have through until the September quarter this year to complete, will be some infill drilling to tighten up some of the assumptions of the mining parameters. And do all the other sort of work you need to complete the DFS. So that's really through to September quarter, and then we're looking to make a financial decision at that point. And so, Danielle, what I suggest for everyone is to look at the company's website, aspiremininglimited.com, the ASX platform and the Proactive Investors platform to see the full detail of the announcement.
David Paull, thank you.
Thank you.